Okay, it's December 22nd, 2015. It's a lot earlier. We've got another 2 months yet. But just the only thing that has been done is the back half. It was finally tilled down 15 to 18 inches. So, end of February, we're going to do the other half. And we'll probably do the one on the right here. Number two garden. That's number three garden in the back. Yeah, that's approximately 55 feet across. And these here in front here, about 17, 18 feet, two of them. That's one, that's two, and three's in the back. We're going to have our okra over here in about four rows. They came out so much last year, we had more than we could handle, but you know, we learned a lot of things last year. We pickled four cases at least of cucumbers, pickles, dill, sweet dill. We did a lot of zucchini. I just bought a hydrator, cheap one, but we're gonna get another one maybe. Just start hydrating stuff too, because hydrating is a lot more efficient. You can just add water to things and it'll bring it back to consistency, and you can cook and lightweight, it's easy to compact it and store it instead of in jars like when you can it. But we planted six cloves of garlic down here. All six came up. Right now it's probably around 64 degrees, 65 degrees out here. Second, like I said, 22nd of December. Let me zoom back out, right there. So I was going to plant onion on back. Let me zoom back out. It's easier to point. So we got the six cloves of garlic here. I'm going to plant onion all the way back there. I've got approximately 24 planted in the house. Two of them are actually coming up. It's been about 2 weeks. So they're real tiny, but they're in that little, them black tray type to bring out here. The plastic will give us until like the end of February, actually, maybe first week of March. But like I say, number three, the western half is all tilled down. It'll have to be broken up anyway, but we're not gonna go down 18 inches like we did it. But that back, the eastern half of number three, then number two over here, and then number one. So it's a lot of work. Like my wife says, you know, it is a lot of work, you know, to get it going. But once you get it going and all that, when you see what you're getting, you're eating all that healthy food. There's nothing you can do really about the rain, the chemtrails in the sky. You know, we have criminals that are running this country. Criminals are running 90% of the countries around the world. They said they're going to get a new world order, which is one world government, one world bank, one world religion. You know, and for all those people that are really religious, you know what that means. So, but they said thousands. I thought it was millions. I'd rather say millions. Millions are going to die fighting against the new world order. I just put myself as being one of those people. Is I'm not going well along with it. I'm going to peacefully deny participating in their system. Stop obeying what they tell you. A police officer is a corporate officer of the United States, which is a corporation. A policeman he polices the common law, which is what we're supposed to be under, not corporate law, corporate jurisdiction, statutes and policies. That's all corporate. Okay, you gotta learn. That's the biggest thing. You gotta learn all this stuff. You know, just keep it practicing. I mean, I've gotten it to the point, so I'll still be nervous as hell when it happens, but I'm going to speak to whatever pulls me over, the police officer, which is probably about 85-90% chance, or a policeman. Like I say, they're getting away with policemen altogether so they can collect revenue. But that's the garden. The past, the past videos have come out here. I've shown you a little bit of everything constantly and just jumped around. But that's how the plastic looks out there right now. It's not really tote. The back is pretty tightened because we did like I did. We did 15 to 18 inches back there actually. And then we'll do that one, pull it, bury the plastic in a little bit. I wanted to get some 2x4s like that one down there. See if I can zoom in on that at least. That 2x4 right there on the edge of the plastic. See, that's why I would like to dig a trench and push that board down like that and on top of it. And it doesn't have to be the whole length, but that at least that one in the middle right there, and then one right down there, one on the side. So I need 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, maybe eight of those 2x4s for the big garden. The only thing that really blocking me from anything is money. So anyway, let's see if we can get some garlic out of here maybe in spring. I believe that grows up like onions too. It grows up a stem and then it falls over and such. But the onion will have to be waited and planted probably till around the end of February, early March. So by the beginning of summer, we might start getting some onions, or midsummer at least. Still trying to want to get the, I can't think of the flower that keeps mosquitoes away. But we're going to have flowers. I don't know if you can see the groove back there. You can see the trench a little bit. That dark line right there in the middle. There's CJ's grave, and then you see that dark line? It goes all the way to the back of the garden. It goes all the way across the back of the garden. And it comes up over here. Over here, though, there's no break. Move this straight over. Across the road. You see the leaves right there? That's all the way back. And then it goes across the back. So that'll be all torch. Two different types of the yellow type sunflowers, which will get butterflies, hummingbirds, and honeybees, a lot of them, because last year we had quite a bit. They were, the big yellow ones were around the back and they weren't planted really good. This year I'm going to do it, February next year, I'm planting everything really, really wisely. They're going to be all mixed, the yellow and the torch, all the way around, so it'll attract everything. I got my target over there. Old hot water heater, that's my target. It's about 75 feet, maybe close to 100. That's it.